Hello friends, welcome to Finance MCQ channel. I am CMA Akula Sridhar and today we'll cover some important questions from management topic, which is also one of the topics from your technical syllabus, apart from accounts, economics, finance, costing and accountancy. Friends, this technical syllabus is having 100 marks in phase 1 and it has 2/3 weightage of your phase 2 of SEBI grade A exam. And friends, you can find the entire technical syllabus of SEBI grade A exam, chapter wise, topic wise on Finance MCQ website in MCQ question format. You can visit the website and practice the entire technical syllabus there. I have put the website link on the description box below. So let's begin and try to solve the MCQ questions along with me. The first question, which one is not a characteristics of planning? Option A, contributes to objective. Option B, pervasive. Option C, planning is continuous. Option D, planning assures guaranteed success. And option E, it involves decision making. So friends, here option D is saying that planning assures guaranteed success, which is incorrect. So the option would be option D. Friends, planning in fact, it gives an assurance to success and makes necessary improvement to overcome obstacles. So it nowhere it will guarantee any success of the organization. Next question, setting targets for sales is a part of which type of plan? Option A, budget. Option B, objective. Option C, strategy. Option D, rules. And last option, none of the above. So friends, here the correct answer would be option A, budget. So friends, budget usually shows expected or anticipated results expressed in numerical terms. And budget can be financial and operational, and it is prepared at every level of the management. Next question, which one is an element of delegation? Option A, responsibility. Option B, accountability. Option C, authority. Option D, all of the above. And option E is both A and B. So friends, remember that all of the above are elements of delegation. So friends, delegation basically takes place when one person gives another the right to perform a work on his behalf. So when a manager is delegating a work to his subordinate, first of all, he has to entrust responsibility to subordinate for performance. And then he has to impart some necessary authority to perform the work freely. And at the same time, he has to create a system of accountability to make sure the work is performed as per the desired standard. Next question, which of the following steps are not involved in staffing process? Option A, estimation of manpower. Option B, recruitment and selection. Option C, placement. Option D, training and development. And last option, none of the above. So friends, here all of the steps are involved in staffing process. So the correct answer would be option E, none of the above. Next question, under dash communication, an individual communicate randomly with other individual without any pattern or so. Option A, gossip chain. Option B, cluster chain. Option C, probability chain. Option D, single strand chain. And option E, none of the above. So friends, the correct answer would be probability chain. So here all these are a types of grapevine or informal communication. In gossip chain, a person actively conveys information to another person around him, while in cluster chain, one person tells something to some selected trustworthy persons. And in the last case of single stranded chain, information is passed through a number of persons like a chain. Next question, which of the following factors helps in improving effective communication? Option A, good listener. Option B, proper feedback. Option C, clarity of idea. Option D, use of proper language. And option E, all of the above. So friends, remember that all of these are factors which helps in improving effective communication. Before moving ahead, let's discuss the question I asked in my previous video. I asked the full form of NSDL and CDSL, which are working as depository in India. So the full form of NSDL is National Securities Depository Limited, while the full form of CDSL is Central Depository Services Limited. Next question, a leader who exercises complete control over its subordinate is an example of dash type of leadership. Option A, participative leadership. Option B, autocratic leadership. Option C, laissez-faire leadership. Option D, all of the above. And option E, none of the above. So friends, here the correct answer is option B, autocratic leadership. So friends, participative leadership is also known as democratic leadership. So where everyone is encouraged to participate and implement decisions. So friends, the question for today's video is that you will tell me what is laissez-faire leadership. So those who know the answer, please comment in the comment box below. We will discuss in tomorrow's video. Next question. Which of the following is a theory of leadership? Option A, behavior theories. Option B, trait theories. Option C, contingency theories. Option D, power and influence theory. And last option, all of the above. So friends, remember that all of these are theories of leadership. So the correct answer would be option E, all of the above. Next question. Staffing and directing is a part of which type of management activity? Option A, management of work. Option B, management of people. Option C, management of operation. Option D, all of the above. And option E, none of the above. So friends, I hope you all know the answer. It's very simple. It is option B, management of people. Next question. This type of objective of an organization deals with its commitment with society at large. So option A, social objective. Option B, organizational objective. Option C, personal objective. Option D, all of the above. And last option, none of the above. So friends, here the question is asking for commitment with the society at large. So the correct option would be option A, social objective. So friends, organizational objective of an organization would be like to utilize human and material resources to the maximum possible advantage for survival, profit and growth of the organization. While personal objectives would be to satisfy the diverse needs of different types of individual who joins the organization, such as giving them good salaries, peer recognition, or working for their personal growth and development, etc. Friends, if you want to practice more such type of MCQ questions from your technical syllabus, I request you to kindly visit Finance MCQ website. It has entire SEBI graded technical syllabus in MCQ format. 2000 plus subject wise, topic wise MCQ questions to practice. It has explanation for correct answer wherever required, plus 25 test series to practice from your technical syllabus. So friends, don't miss this golden opportunity and increase your selection chances significantly. Website link is given in the description box below. If you have any questions, please write in the comment box below. I will try to address them and I will come up with new MCQ questions to practice on SEBI grade exam. Till then, take care and thank you for watching.